Thank you. exactly we did. 6.5 minutes. So these were the group members. We tried our best to give nicknames to everybody. Some of these are true, some of these are totally fake. But yeah. Moving on. So behavior. So essentially, our mind has 5 parts. We talk about the colonial organization development, defending the colony, the role of bees as pollinators, bee signaling, dances and communication, and the importance of bees. So let's go in that order as well. But bees works, so let's have a look. So there are 3 basic classes of bees. I'm sure all of us know this. There's the drones, which are haploid males. Some internet site I read described them as fat and hairy, which is a pretty decent description. And no offense to the other drones, okay? So they're stingless. Their role is just to maintain the bee. Then workers are the guys who really maintain the beehive. Now the girls who maintain the beehive. So they sterilize the hive from stuff, and then they go collect pollen and nectar. Queen is the mean green egg-laying machine. So let's talk about drones. So drones are, how the mating happens is that multiple drones chase the queen in something called a nuptial flight. And if a drone succeeds, then his abdomen explodes along with what he planted to be made. So he dies. And if he does not succeed, then he pretty much gets ousted of the colony. So it's like a no-win scenario for the drones, really. But again, it continues to be colony, so that's important. The honeymoon begins after that. And after the impregnation, the queen bee lays her egg to the wax cell, and then the larva pupates fed by the worker bees. We'll come to what is being fed later. And the queen can actually select which workers will become drones and which will become workers by selecting the size of the chamber. So if you looked at our hexagon, the sizes were different. Okay, so the workers, they go outside, they bring back nectar and pollen from the flowers, and it is processed into what we know as honey, beeswax, etc. Some of it is turned into royal jelly, which is like a more thicker, more sugary version of honey. And that contains a higher number of enzymes as well, which help convert sugars. So that is fed to all larvae in the first few days of their existence, but after that, non-queens are kind of cut off from the royal jelly, and only queens are fed that. The royal jelly also contains enzymes that help the development of ovaries, which form the queen. And now we'll talk about the defense. So we constantly face threats from several external aggressors. So yellow jackets are a deadly one. Wasps in general are a danger. We showed a yellow jacket as evidenced by yellow jacket. And Japanese honeybees have a very unique way of dealing with aggressors. So they formed a ball around the aggressor and start vibrating very fast and moving around. So this draws a lot of heat, and the hornet or the wasp actually gets cooked alive in the process. So there are also like bee guards. So they go collect pollen flowers and the pollination process. And now we talk about the bee dances. So there's a long dance, which is for short range, and a waggle dance, which is for long range. And there's a sickle dance also, which is for an intermediate. And then bees leave the hive when the temperature gets hot, and they come back when the temperature gets cold at night. There are other dances like the alarm dance that we showed now. And what would happen if bees died out? Bees spontaneously plants, bee plants. No more bees, no more world.